Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Women Gupshup. We all want to be mentally strong, you know, and a lot has been said about, you know, mental health, and it's very, very important, we all know. So today we will talk about some things which makes us mentally weak, and the things which we should avoid, you know, to regain our mental strength. So what are they? Mental strength is all about, you know, our resilience and control. So when we have these things, then definitely we are mentally strong. But some things that we do which makes us mentally weak, and we should definitely check them, and you know, we should erase them from our life. First is pressure of making right decision. We always have a pressure of making right decision, you know. If we get to know, if I talk about myself, if I get to know that, you know, my decision was not right and it has affected someone, so definitely I'll be, very, very affected, you know, and I'll feel very guilty and everything. So the point is that, you know, we can't be always right. We have to accept that thing, that we can't be always right. Whether it's our child's decisions, whether it's our family decisions, whether it's our financial decisions, whether it's our career decisions, we can't be always right. And when we, you know, free us from this pressure of be correct always, which I have already talked about in my last videos, and you know, we always want to be correct, and that is the pressure which we have. So it's okay, it's human to make mistakes, but definitely we should learn from our mistakes. Second is self-indulgence. Self-indulgence is one thing which gives us temporary relief, you know, but in long run it doesn't give the benefits. Self-indulgence, I would give an example, like if I have an addiction of something, maybe it can be tea or coffee or anything, I know that, you know, it can harm me, you know, if I take in a very large quantity, it can harm me, but still I'll keep on taking it, and there is no control on my mind that I should not take all these things. So this is the self-indulgence problem, which, you know, prevents us from doing things which are right. Because we don't want to. We are so weak, you know, we don't want to do the right things. We should do exercise, we should do meditation, but we feel that, no, I just want to grab a cup of coffee and I just want to lie down. I just want this. It happens with me also. But the problem is it makes us mentally weak. So I will definitely make a video on dopamine detox, which is a very, very important topic which I read about. So that you will see in the coming videos. Next is afraid of being alone. We are always afraid of being alone, you know. We feel that, okay, we'll be left alone, you know. We develop trust issues sometimes when we have fights and everything. We should stick to that trust, you know, that we will not be alone. Our parents are with us, you know, our family is with us. Our family is with us, and you know, and definitely we should. There are some moments when we feel that, okay, I'm just alone, nobody's there for me, but definitely we should come out of that and just tell yourself, no, I have my family and I have my backup. That is very, very important. Next is dwelling on past. Sometimes what happens, we want to relive the memories which we we have, and we just want to change everything in the past. And I have done this a lot, you know, I was always in the past. And then I realized that, you know, after gaining this knowledge, I realized when you are constantly in the past, it ruins your present and future. So definitely you should come out of that past and you create your present so that you can have a good future. Definitely. It's not just an idiom. It's a very, very important fact also. Next is you give up early. Sometimes what happens, it happens with me all the time, when I am on some health track, you know, and suddenly I don't get results and I give up. But now I have slowly in last few years, I realized that, you know, you should have that patience, and you know, you should wait for some time to get the benefits of anything. It can be meditation. I see people, you know, they say, oh, I did meditation for 1 week and nothing happened. Yeah, it didn't work for me. But the point is that these things are fruitful for many people, and you should definitely give a chance. You should definitely have a patience for all these things. Definitely they will give the results for your mental health and as well as physical health. This is again a very, very common thing, to be liked by everyone. It is a huge pressure, you know, to be liked by everyone. Everyone should like me. Believe me, I have seen all these things, and now I am trying to come out of them. That's why I, you know, made this video so that I can share this with you also. And you know, we have this pressure of to be liked by everyone. Everyone should like me. My family, my bosses, my friends, everyone should like me. No one should see any bad thing about me in any light. No bad light should be there for me. But believe me, no matter how much you try, there are some moments, you know, when you are not liked by people. And it's fine. It's fine because you can't be liked by everyone all the time. It's a huge pressure which we all face, you know, and it's okay. So next is self-criticism again, that I don't have a good body, I don't have good job, I am not having finances big, my house is not that big, and you know, and I don't have a big car. So much self-criticism, you know. So what happens, this self-criticism has a very, very bad effect on our health and mental, physical and mental health. Already I have discussed with you about the You Can Heal Your Life. So there we saw that, you know, how badly it affects our health. So it is very, very important to have a right attitude and use affirmations. They are very, very important. Your emotions control you. See, when I started meditation, I learned these things that, you know, feelings are like a boat. You are sitting in a boat and feelings are like a boat, you know, that, and you are riding that boat. So what happens if you don't ride it properly? Feelings can take you anywhere, you know. So it is very, very important that you should have a check on these feelings and these emotions, and you should be very, very practical that time. We always feel that no, I am feeling bad right now, I don't want to get up, I don't want to do anything. But the thing is that feelings are temporary. You should be very, very practical, because feelings can take you in the wrong direction. If you are completely dependent only on your feelings and emotions, they will never give you the right answer. So right answer will only be given when you have a check on your emotions and feelings. If you are completely, you know, submerged in the feelings, then you can't get the right answers, because the answer should be practical as well as it should be, you know, according to our feelings. So it should be a combination of both, you know. So it should be practical. So these were the things I wanted to talk to you, you know, because again, my favorite book, Emotional Intelligence, I just took out some concepts from there and I discussed with you. So definitely I just want that, you know, you please use these things, and you know, it is very, very important, especially in this time of you know, in this year. It's been a very hard year for all of us. So definitely take care of your physical and mental health, and please share if you have any tips for these things, because they are very, very important things. I really feel that. And please share something in comment section if you feel like, and if you like my video, please like it, share it, and please subscribe my channel, and please don't forget to click the bell icon, because it will give you my regular video updates. Thank you so much. Ciao.